All right, hello everyone, and welcome to the Beyond the Summit coverage of the TI6 EU regional qualifiers. This is going to be day number two here, and we've already got an action-packed lineup going. Looks like our first game will be a best of one between Fantastic Five and Power Rangers. Definitely excited to see how this plays out. I'm Android. I'm being joined today by Fogged. How you doing?
I'm tired.
You're tired?
Yes.
We got so many Red Bulls.
I know. Game one as well. Oh God. One of eight.
It's a long day today, but it should keep us awake here. EU, definitely a very bloody region here. We can go ahead and switch into the draft. Already underway now between Fantastic Five and PR. Starting out with an Elder Titan. That's pretty meta. Not anything too unusual.
Yeah, both teams are just gonna... Seems like people are just sticking with popular heroes for the most part, but Fantastic Five does have their big Radiant groove, and this is pretty much two of their most staple heroes that they've been playing with, the Slaughter and the Air Spirit.
All right, so going on now, PR, what do you think they're going to pick up here for their big cores? Because Elder Titan can combo well with a whole lot of play styles.
They have a bunch of different like specific things that they can do, but I know they really like the mag, obviously, for Arise. And we did see that combo come out, I mean, from Miracle, from OG when they were at Manila. They did, like, Elder Titan mag. But, yeah, Tyranid pick. This has also been rising a lot more, basically, like, every single game we're seeing now. It's not really the Lifestealer era right now again. Switched really quickly. Now it's the Terrorblade era.
Yeah, and this is a really early pick. Now it is going to be one of those priority bans, like you mentioned, just because it has been picked up so much. But second pick Terrorblade means that Fantastic Five now have three picks to react to that. What's your best option up against that big old split pusher?
Well, they already have two really good options of dealing with him, so don't really know if they need to think about that just yet, but they're just going to ban out the comfort heroes from PR. So yeah, the Shadow Demon ban, obviously, because it works so well with Terrorblade, obviously how it complements with Illusions, the mag, like we were saying, you know, PR, it's Arise. You might as well just ban the mag. It's his most comfortable hero. And the combo with Elder Titan is really easy. Just stomp into Skewer. Fantastic Five, this opener is just, it's really easy to work around because you have massive magical damage, you have massive physical, you have objective takers, team fight. It's well-rounded already just from the first two, so they've got a lot of options. Pretty much just however they want to take their draft. And this is, like I was saying, like their staple. They really like getting these two heroes.
Now, both of these teams are still looking for a secondary support, and Disruptor's been a huge pickup, and now we're on to four bans from each team. No bans, no picks on it. Do you think we're going to see it, or do you have to pick up a little bit more of a survivable support?
Fantastic Five could pick it. They could do Venge. They could do Disruptor. They're big fans of Oracle. I don't know if this game it's decent versus Terrorblade, just because you can burst him down. But he doesn't really provide much else. And yeah, okay, so they just get a different bursting support. Radiant
team. Yeah, definitely a lot of utility there on the line. He's got that Hex, he's got that Earth Spike. So from level 2, you have a ton of lockdown against whoever PR are going to be putting in that offlane.
Yeah, he's a great illusion clearer as well. So when Terrorblade just starts spamming out the obnoxious Conjure image, you can either Mana Drain and to instant kill it or Hex to instant kill it. He has a lot of different methods.
All right, so PR moving on here. They still got to pick up a mid hero. There's a lot of hate on the mids recently. We have Magnus obviously banned out against Arise, but Alchemist, Tinker, and Death Prophet taken out. So there's fewer options to work with. DK is still a very survivable option, but I don't think they need that much push.
Yeah, DK would be... It's okay. It works well with their lineup. They've got a lot of options right now. Timbersaw is okay here. It's not very great versus like Earth Spirit, Lion Slaughter. There's a lot of disable, but... It's a pick that's just been coming more and more popular when people just don't even care. It's like, oh, they have lots of disable, whatever, it's a Timbersaw. Don't know if PR will go for that though. It's Secret likes it a lot with the Elder Titan, but it doesn't really synergize with Natural Order at all. It's just a lot of damage on top of Elder Titan. So PR goes for the safe Venge.
Yeah, so lots of utility now in their support duo. Those two are probably gonna be able to roam around, and that means that Power Rangers may want to stick with a more Radiant survivable core that doesn't need a lot of babysitting in lane. You know, if you pick something up that needs constant support from your position 4 or 5, then you can't rotate around, you can't get those early kills with the Elder Titan Venge.
Yeah, they're probably going to have to emphasize a little bit on their short lane just at the start, just because it's Earth Spirit, Slardar, you don't really want... Fantastic Five still has the opportunity, like, the option to move the Slardar in the short lane, of course, but... They definitely want to just get their short lane steady just with the Terrorblade. The Elder Titan can kind of walk around and do his own thing, because... Level 1 with Metamorphosis, you don't really need too much help to zone out an offlaner unless it's a dual lane.
Alright, Batrider picked up here. So is that going to be a mid-bat or offlane?
Probably offlane. I don't think they really like playing it with like a It ends up like you're pretty much guaranteeing yourself into a single core lineup. Sure, you have Elder Titan and Venge, which really boost up your damage and everything, but single core Terror Blade into that Mass Disable and Timbersaw Burst. You probably want to have that Batrider go offlane. And then pick up another semi core in the mid lane. It's usually what Power Rangers tends to go for, at least for Arise. I know yesterday he did play a mid bat, but.
Yeah, I'm really liking the lockdown coming up for Power Rangers. They've got so many different ways to go and grab their prey and keep it on lock. Now Slardar, he is going to have that blink at some point. Earth Spirit obviously can just roll away. Timbersaw, super slippery. But as long as they can assure a kill on at least one person, I think Power Rangers have the opportunity to start ganking pretty early, go in, find picks, and just keep that snowball rolling.
Yeah, the combo is... It's not a crazy amount of team fight right now for PR. It's pretty much just the Elder Titan, but... They have the opportunities with the, obviously the Astral Spirit combo with Batrider gives you vision so you can blink in and get a good lasso off. They have, of course, Wave of Terror as well for vision. And we've been seeing the vision game work. It just puts a lot of impact in these games. Just every time one team has a little bit more vision, it's like, oh, they get the opportunity to initiate, and they end up winning the fights most of the time because of it.
All right, so last ban out, it will be a Slark. So Fantastic Five, they definitely still need to pick up their position one unless they move the Slardar to that long lane, which I'm not quite sure would be the best pick here. But taking out the Slark, taking out that Snowball. Now PR, most likely looking for a mid, like you mentioned, but could pick up an offlaner. A lot of them are banned out.
Yeah.
The pool's a little bit small for that.
Both options are still there, depending on what they really want to go for. That's always the nice thing about picking like this. It's like, okay, like you can't really... Be sure that the Batrider is mid or offlane. It always keeps options open. Trick your enemy.
Yeah, I mean, at this point, I think PR may still be looking for that flexibility. They might not be locked into one place just yet, trying to read what Fantastic Five are putting out.
Yeah, they're playing... Fantastic Five has not picked like their actual, basically, like, carry at all, so they're playing with a Terror Blade core. So they shouldn't even feel too pressured right now going into late game. Okay, so they do go another full offlane core. So it is the mid bat.
All right, Arise bat. We'll see how much it can get done. Assuming this is going to be a Timbersaw mid, it's pretty difficult for him to go through and get any sort of real harass. Timbersaw is going to be super survivable, but Batrider should be able to keep at least even in terms of CS.
Yeah, Batrider should do just fine in this matchup. It's also a pain for Timbersaw because his turn rate is quite ass. And okay, Chaos Knight. That's like an Illidan specialty. It's actually something that he loves a lot, and it's great versus Void. It's heavy lockdown, so they have Lion. They have an insane amount of stun and actually a lot of damage. And PR, if the Elder Titan doesn't have his ultimate, they don't really have like a crazy amount of AOE to deal with the illusions if Illidan's able to get that farm up. But I really like that Void pick. Like I was mentioning how PR doesn't really have like a crazy amount of team fight right now. The Void just basically locks everything together, lets you land easy Elder Titan ultimates, also and a lockdown on top of different form of counter initiation to help out the Terror Blade if he gets initiated on. They have the swap now. They have the Void Chrono. They have multiple different ways of protecting him with frontliners. And also, time dilation into Timbersaw and Earth Spirit is pretty damn good.
Now, every time I've seen Illidan on the CK, he has either a Wisp or another really hard support to help him out and babysit him. Do you think that the Earth Spirit and Lion are going to be enough to make sure that Illidan has a safe time?
Yeah, should be fine with the Lion, especially just because it's looking like it's just going to be a Void offlane. So Lion and CK and Earth Spirit should be able to zone him out pretty easily.
All right, let's talk about these. Highest total magic or pure damage done to heroes. So...
By 25. So, because I would say Timber, but by 25 he might not be going crazy yet.
With Lion, once he gets his finger on Lion, just nuking him down. But
I'm probably gonna go with Elder Titan myself.
Oh yeah.
Just because he's just gonna keep walking around throwing spirits at people and stomping. If he hits like multi-hero stomps, Timber Batrider, I think, just because of the positioning. The bat's gonna be in mid, so he's gonna be like pressuring Fantastic Five a lot. I'll go with Elder Titan.
Highest amount of physical damage. Done to a hero. I think CK, if he crits, is going to be stupid high. So I'm going to up to 1,000. What do you think?
Trying to see if how far I think that this game is actually going to go. Yeah, I'll go for a 751 to 1,000. Will a tower be denied? I'll go yes, whatever. Yeah. Not.
Player with the most last hits by 7 minutes.
That's going to be Illidan.
What is it?
I'm going to put Illidan. You can put whichever ones you want, honestly.
I mean, Illidan's solid, but I think Goddamn's going to get a lot done on that Terror
Yeah.
Blade.
Either or.
I'm putting Goddamn in.
Go ahead.
All right.
It's good to switch it up a little bit.
Quick introduction here before the blood gets underway here on the side of Power Rangers. We're going to have Goddamn on that position one Terrorblade. Over here, it looks like J4 playing up that Roman Venge. Arise on the mid Batrider. Over here towards the mid lane, it will be Big Num on that position four Titan. And finally, Cheshire Cat on the roaming Void in the off lane.
What the hell? I have invisible heroes. Do you see this?
Oh man, where are they at?
Look, he's actually look, the other Titan's invisible. I gotta reconnect.
Yeah, that is certainly a bug here.
They're invisible. I just saw him pick up items.
You just got nothing going on. Now on the side of Fantastic Five, it will be Pasha playing up that Slardar. Over here, it's going to be Yol on the Earth Spirit, BZZ on the Timbersaw, RMN, Taunton on that Lion, and finally Illidan on that Core CK. We're really getting that taunt underway, man.
Wow, I actually can't see heroes. They're invisible.
Here, I got the big screen here. You can obs off me if you
want. Yeah, I think I'm going to have to. The invisible Void is currently blocking the mid lane.
Oh, Crush coming in, but Batrider still secures the rune. Now, Pasha going to be going in. It looks like he's going to take a fair amount of harassment. Should be completely fine. He has picked up that Stout Shield, so super typical Slardar off lane. Do you think he goes for the Talon at all, trying to dip out of the lane to get some Jungle Farm, or can he stay in the lane for a long time?
He should probably just go for the Talon. It's too risky. He's going to be able to get a bit of levels at the once the meta goes down at first, but still. I think he just wants to pressure because he knows the Elder Titan's not going to be down there. So he's just like, alright, it's a dual lane. I might as well try to get at least level 2, and then maybe I can get out of there.
So Arise, no surprise. Leveling up that Napalm, slamming it out onto BZZ. Do you think they're going to get any kill potential, or will BZZ just be completely fine with that reactive armor?
He should be fine. He just has to watch out. He can't let himself get like 3 or 4 sticky charges.
Roll in, connects onto the bat, Arise. He's squishy, but not that squishy, and also has 2 fairy fires. Man, these predictions, they're neat to call, but then in the first couple of minutes, the last hits keep switching around, so it just plops out over and over again in the side boxes.
Yeah, I actually thought the Earth Spirit would just straight up start in the offlane, because what's he really going to accomplish versus a Batrider mid? Your Timbersaw is... There's no way that you get kill potential on a Batrider with Timbersaw or Spirit. If you get a kill, then it's just like, okay, Bat made a huge mistake.
Now, really deep roam hit here. Yol looking for some contest onto Cheshire Cat, who's just kind of bailed on the offlane. He picks up that Iron Talon very early and just wants to go through, getting those levels, getting that farm. Do you think he's going to get punished for this?
It's just going to be Earth Spirit pretty much following him. Oh, he lets himself get stacked up. Okay.
Yeah, that was... I wonder how many stacks of Napalm that was. And Arise may end up going down here. He got that creep aggro on him, but no. It's going to be the melee creep going back in. And he gets very low. May have to back off. Again, only the Fairy Fire. He's flying himself out his bottle, but I don't think that's going to be a whole lot. So he's going to dip out, and that will allow BCC to get some farm and make up some of that deficit that he just lost there.
Yeah, he had to just... let him get too many sticky stacks, but it was also Arise doing the smart play. He picks up very, very early boots pretty much right away.
Ignum going in, but gets crushed up, rolls on. Can Cheshire Cat do anything about this? Elder Titan does get a double damage rune. Can they turn this? Yol gonna get punched down. Looks like he's going into the Roche Pit. Leap in. One more hit should do it, and he will not get the Roche deny. Now Pasha looks like he will get away with his life. Cheshire Cat, if he lands the bash of his lifetime, maybe, but looks like Pasha should back off here. Or not. Ah, just slithering around, having some fun with it.
Mess with your enemy.
Absolutely.
Oh, I can actually... I'm starting to be able to see creeps and stuff a little bit on mine. But yeah, Void's still invisible. So is Elder Titan.
That's very, very weird, man. I don't think I've ever seen that bug in Dota TV.
Yeah, oops.
So Timbersaw making up for that deficit a little bit. He is loused hitting the bat just by a couple of creeps. So he'll keep himself survivable, and as long as he doesn't go down too many more times after that, he should be completely fine.
Yeah, he just... like he can't let himself get stacked up. He has to just manipulate the wave better. He really shouldn't be dying in that lane.
No. Right now, Pasha slithering away. J4, only level 2. Again, has to split experience with Goddamn. Isn't able to hop into the jungle as it is controlled up by the Void. So, you know, Void's farming alright. He's getting a couple of last hits there, but only 6 in the jungle with the Iron Talon, and could get rotated on by Yol. Again, I think he's just keeping eyes, splitting XP, but not able to really go in and get the job done.
Yeah, just splitting XP. He doesn't really need to do much else. He can't pressure a Void. If he rolls in, he just gets right-clicked. So just stealing the XP is fine. Being obnoxious.
Now 3 stacks landing back over here in the bot lane. We could have some action going down. 4 stacks.
He has to watch out.
Yeah, I mean, the Firefly is going to come back on in. Can they get the grab here? Timber Chain away. Batrider is only level 5, not going to be picking up that lasso yet, but down bottom, Vengeful Spirit goes through, gets the kill onto the Slardar. That's a lot of lockdown here. That's Slardar's first death, but he can't keep playing that aggressively. He keeps going in, looking for that harass, trying to be a bully, but he's the one that ends up falling.
He can't step up whenever meta's up. Anytime the meta's up, if he steps up, he's dead. He has to expect this. he has to expect the Elder Titan and the Venge to just be in position, because one stun and you're just gonna get either stomped and then followed up. And yeah, Terrorblade obviously deals out a crap ton of damage when he metas, especially this early in the game. And you're Slardar, so you're low armor at first, and then if you use sprint, you're pretty. I mean, you're high armor, but you're if you use sprint, you take extra damage. So.
Yeah, so he's going to come back into lane. Hasn't opted to bail out just yet, and it'll be surprising to see if he does end up going, grabbing the Talon and leaving, because Pasha has to play very, very safe. If he gives up too much, then that's just a Terrorblade getting off to a great start, and you can't afford that. On top here, Cheshire Cat, they know he's here. RMN's going to be eaten through the trees, does have the Hex, does have the stun combo. Illidan already wailing on the tower. They go through, they will get the Hex, they got to keep Cheshire Cat on lockdown. There they go, the Chaos Bolt with the Reality Rift and the Earth Spike. One more hit will do it there. Oh, he gets off the leap. Yol going through with the blocks. Do they have the raw damage? Looks like the boulder will connect, and they will get the kill there. Go in the way of Lion. That's going to be a nice chunk of gold going the way of RMN. Already picked himself some boots and 600 gold on top of that.
Yeah, nice awareness there by them. They put the ward down behind the tower as well. They know the Cheshire Cat's on the side. And now they get the kill on him. It's just a nice lockdown, nice play, good spell usage.
Six napalm stacks though on the Timber Saw. He's burning fast. Gonna go in with the Whirling Death. Arise actually the one in trouble. One Timber Chain picks him off. He got very greedy there.
Yeah. That's pretty much what should happen. If the Batrider goes for the dives, you have to be in a position to be able to turn it. And that's what also happens when you pick up the Raindrop. It blocks a bit of damage. Not really that great versus Batrider because it's a constant damage, so that pretty much just ticks instantly once he has a few stacks on you and gets Fireflies over you, but still. Lots of damage, especially when Batrider goes to dive you in that mid tower. You have trees all around you to give that burst potential.
So looking at what's happening here in the safe lanes, Goddamn getting a lot of farm here, 38, but getting outlasted by Illidan on the Chaos Knight, who's had almost a free lane. Again, Void kind of dipped into the jungle for a long while, and is it a mistake to leave Illidan alone for this long?
They can't really pressure him with the heroes they have, so it's kind of just you have to just take what you can get at this point. Elder Titan, I feel like, should be maybe getting a little bit more out of what he's doing, but, I mean, I can't see him, so it's actually getting annoying. But he's been involved in two kills, and every time it's rotated with Metamorphosis, it's been good, but I feel like maybe it's a little bit of miscommunication between him and Arise, because those are easy kill setups. That's how you kill the Timber Saw. You bring your Elder Titan, you get one stomp on him when you have, like, three or four stacks, and that's going to be a dead Timber pretty much instantly. Especially because Arise, level 6 now, he has Lasso. He has the Flame Break as well to stop the Timber Chain.
Alright, next up, PZZ will pick himself up his Arcane, so has that little extra bit of mana sustain and will be able to sit in lane and feel nice, but Arise.
They're going on bottom right now.
Alright, here we go. There sees the Terrorblade in that Metamorphosis form. Crush will land on the Big Gnome, but slither away, Pasha. He's not going to be able to get anything out of this, but will not lose his life. In fact, he's going to go right back into lane, right back into contesting that little pull there. And
nice. Correct.
I got incorrect. You won.
I won.
Gotta listen to you more. For now, yeah. Goddamn, gonna get the most out of that Metamorphosis form, but not able to push up the tower. That's gonna be a little bit costly. If he is breaking the wave and is able to push up without that big old big guy form.
Arise pushing in the mid lane, just using Firefly. Pretty much 30 seconds before the rune timing, pushing the wave in best as possible so he can't get ganked either because he knows the Earth Spirit's missing.
Ward in, Arise, they know he's here. Does Yol rotate in on this? The deep dive if they want to go, but just booking it out there, making sure that Yol does not lose anything.
Yeah, not a good place to be. Easily being able to get lassoed up and just brought down there, so good roll away.
J4 taking out the ward, nice use of the sentries, and that's going to be a little bit of wasted time there for the Earth Spirit, who has been trying, has been rotating around the map a lot, but not really able to participate in a whole lot of kills. But again, we are 8 minutes in, only 5 kills. Not going to be a huge deal. Last hits still heavily being taken by Illidan because he hasn't been contested. Net worth, similar story.
Yeah, I feel like Pasha could have benefited a lot more from just honestly going to the jungle. He's getting like not really great of levels. He's not really last hitting. He's finally getting some CS now into the tower, but I feel like he could have just probably gone Iron Talon and had a TP every time that they push, because you're going to expect PR to eventually do that, the timing push with the Metamorphosis, especially just because they have the Avenge Elder Titan and a Terrorblade in the short lane. They might as well do the timings. But now their PR's not actually pushing the short lane, which I'm not sure if this is the best idea for them. They're just going to put the Terrorblade in the jungle and give Elder Titan levels in the short lane. But now that gives a lot of space to Pasha to farm.
Absolutely. I mean, he's making up a lot of time here, already having about 600 gold. Buys up his Tranquils and could be working towards his Blink Dagger next. Group up mid. They could go for a smoke here. They could just go for a charge into him. They bring in Goddamn to the mid lane, and they want to get something out of this.
Yeah, looks like both teams kind of okay with chilling out and farming for a little bit. Timbersaw is resorting to the jungle. Terrorblade resorting to the jungle. Batrider resorting to the jungle. I think Batrider might be farming a stack, but not sure.
He's just going through, he's having fun. And, you know, not a very action-packed game. Again, in a game with a Terrorblade with a CK, you're not going to see a whole lot of action minute one, but it'll be interesting to see when the power spikes start happening, when the teams group up and decide it's all right to get really aggressive. Which team do you think is going to go on the offensive first?
Probably PR, just because they have the mid Batrider, and he's very, very close to that Blink Dagger, so he's going to probably make the first move. They should probably put some pressure on the CK. They know he went Midas, and he's now going back for the armlet, so he's going to be pretty buff, because Terrorblade does not go Midas, obviously, so he's got that little bit of benefit. Little bit of bonus going for the Chaos Knight currently than over the Terrorblade.
Yeah, he's now working towards that armlet. Should have it up at a very reasonable time. That's going to be a lot of sustain. He's already picked up that point in Phantasm, which, you know, sometimes we see CKs hold on to that point until they're ready to leave lane, until they're ready to go up and actually start the push, but just grabbing it out is going to be nice. He's going to have it if he needs it, if things get tough, and looks like tier 2 pressure going to be on the menu here for Illidan. No one is doing anything about him, and I feel like, especially an Illidan CK, you've got to really apply that early pressure or he's going to snowball out of control.
Yeah, looks like Fantastic Five want to make the first move this game. They are smoked up with three heroes, Slaughter, Earth Spirit, and Lion. Lion has Finger. They know the Terrorblade's just jungling. The nice thing about PR's lineup, though, now is that they have the Void and the Batrider with a Blink. The Void is level 6 and the Batrider has a Blink Dagger, so let's see how this fight
Smoke's going to pop here. They
out.
Know it rises.
They know.
Nice ward being plopped down. God damn, he's waiting in the trees. Lots of pings coming out as the Radiant continue to bring heroes into the pool, and it looks like F5 won't get that jump that they wanted.
That is not a place for them to fight. That is getting caught there, it would be... They might get like one or two kills, but they have
VCC
to be very careful.
VCC getting punished, but Reality Rift in. Arise is going to get bolted up and can't get away here. The Firefly will end at some point. There they go in, and that's going to be a nice Phantasm used. Earth Splitter coming out. It looks like so far Batrider the only one to fall. Everyone on F5 feeling relatively survivable. And I think the fight just disengages from here, so they go through. They get a mid-Bat pick on the back of a really nice CK play.
I'm not sure. I think Bignum got clipped by a stun or something because he was echo-stomping on top of the Batrider to protect him, and it didn't actually go off, so I'm not sure if he got clipped by something, but big opportunity missed for PR there. They expected the gank to happen, and they still got caught by it just because they decided to go in rather than let F5 make the mistake. They made the mistake themselves, so bit of a mistake there for PR. They even used the lasso. They didn't have to commit the chrono, but they used lasso and they used other Titan ultimate, so it's going to slow their roll a little bit, and it's going to allow Fantastic Five to farm up the items that they want right now, which is, you know, the armlet on the CK, some stat items on the, some just HP and stuff on the Timbersaw, which he has a soul booster already, so he's on his way toward his Bloodstone already.
Yeah, I'm quite surprised we haven't seen the Chrono debut just yet. Goddamn going in, does pop out that reflection. They want to go into BZZ. He's got the Timber Chain. Did they really follow this up? No. Just forcing him back, but that's going to be PR making a lot of space here. Kill score completely even. Overall net worth is going to be slightly in favor of F5. Similar story with XP, but it's anyone's game.
Yeah, still really early to really call or tell anything that's happening. Both teams are playing pretty slow-paced. They want to just farm up. They don't want to take any big team fights yet, but it should be happening within the next couple minutes. Everyone's getting the level 6s. PR is going to have their lasso up as one line being dove top, and he actually gets the lasso committed on him.
Oh, that's going to be a pretty deep dive now. Arise in some trouble. Once again, just going in, the Firefly burning down the trees. You can't win the tree game against Timbersaw, and he's going to get smacked out. Slardar picking himself up his first kill of the game, so trading a lion for a bat, and that's a really big commit from Arise without a whole lot of escape plan at the end of that. So overall, that's going to be a solid gold change, solid XP change in favor of F5.
Yeah, PR is distributing their money very well, though. And they have a lot of they have like such a big combo. I mean, with the other Titan Void, team fighting into them is going to be super difficult for F5 until they have a means of initiation. The Slaughter is going to need a Blink Dagger, otherwise it's super hard for them to actually get a good fight off. It's really just PR has much easier opportunities to start the fight, to counter-initiate and everything right now until Slaughter has that Blink Dagger.
So Illidan coming up. He was scouted out in the river, so he's not going to be super sneaky. And now big group up from the Radiant Heroes. It's like they do have a smoke on the Batrider if they want to use that to go for the jump. But with no lasso, it seems like they don't have a whole lot of plan.
Funny, too. I'm mentioning Slardar's Blink Dagger. Meanwhile, RMN online basically has his Blink.
Leap in. They get the Chrono onto Illidan. Can they follow it up? The Earth Splitter coming out. Yol, he's looking to rotate in. As soon as the Chrono's done, they will go through. It looks like Illidan, he's going to live here. Gets the Armlet. Gets the Phantasm. Frag back in. Arise. Getting nuked down by the Finger. And that's going to be more kills going the way of F5. So far, this gank is not going in their favor. Roll back in. Bignum looking tough. He's trying to survive this gank, but it looks like F5 have no trouble diving tower. Their Spirit's coming out. They're trying to get some vision. Illidan with the Armlet may have to watch his health pool here. He's going to get stomped up, could get brought down. In fact, may end up doing so. He's ticking down very, very low. 3 health on him. Timbersaw coming through with the Timber Chain, with the Whirling Death. Bignum, he's booking it. Can he get away fast enough? BZZ looking for the kills, driving him around here in the jungle. Those trees are super speedy. They're going for the stomp, but finally they will secure the kill. Illidan scraping by with a fragment of health on that one. That was terrifying.
That's huge for F5. That was without the Slardar completely. He literally just was farming top the entire time. PR gets kind of caught off guard. I don't think they were expecting the Armlet at this point already. And CK just too tanky. You blew 2 ultimates on him, and he still didn't even die. They just don't have the damage right now without the Counterblade in the position within the fights.
Yeah, a lot of that came off the back of Illidan just getting exactly what he wanted to out of lane for the first 15 full minutes. And being able to pop that Phantasm perfectly timed on him. No hesitation whatsoever.
And now they've got Lion with a Blink Dagger already. So they've got their means of initiation before. And it's before the Slardar even has his Blink Dagger too on their team. So it's very impressive by RMN.
All right, now so Chaos Knight sitting on a couple of pennies here. Almost 1,300 gold. Does he go in for an early BKB? Does he pick up, what's he looking for?
On which, CK, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, he can go for the BKB. It's the safest play, but I don't know if Illidan always does that. He might just go for the heart or something. Like he goes some crazy builds on the CK. This guy doesn't care.
Avenge waiting in the wings. No one knows J4 is here.
Mid lane,
could easily get punished. They get the drag though here in the top lane. They're looking for more. They will get a stomp. BZZ in some serious trouble. Commits suicide on that new Bloodstone, and that's going to be a tower committed for Power Rangers. They get something now mid lane. There's going to be another push coming through. Did they get any kills on the back of that? The Void?
Yeah, RMN gets, he blinks in mid and gets a Hex off on the Void, and then they just, yeah, stun, double stun, burst him down really quickly. And that's big, though, because also PR expended 2 ultimates again, and they lost a hero while getting it. Luckily, they did get the tower off of it, so as much as the ultimates are quote-unquote wasted, they did force a suicide, so Bloodstone charges are reduced, and they do get objective out of it, so the ults pretty much got them what they wanted anyway.
All right, so Illidan secures another tower around the map, and now that's going to be a big focus. You see them draw on the map down here. They really want this tier 1 bot because that gives them so much control over the Radiant Jungle, which, you know, Yol's already been rotating in and going into the Radiant Jungle all game, putting up that vision. Dire vision right now. That's crazy. Look how much there is. They got this Observer scouting out everything going on in the lane, bringing in the sentries as well. So Dire definitely stepping up the vision game.
Very common Dire wards. You know, you really want to, as soon as you are able to enter the enemy, enter the Radiant Jungle, you want to get a ward down there, and then you tend to want to have at least one defensive ward in your own jungle so you can see if any of the Radiant are farming your jungle, like the Batrider who is currently doing that. So this is pretty much perfect warding from F5 right now.
So F5, it looks like they are hitting a position of power, but you can never really tap out a Terrorblade again. You give him a little bit of space, he'll absolutely get the most out of it. Illidan's farming up very nicely. Now, does CK hold on to that big power spike till the end, or will he eventually fall victim to Terrorblade's natural scaling?
He actually will match up pretty decently just because of the cooldown for meta. They both have kind of the same issue. It's like CK has to play around Phantasm while Terrorblade has to play around Metamorphosis, and they share the same cooldown. So it's pretty much whoever has the better cooldowns up, it will pretty much win the man fight. And it's, of course, you know, if there's other people around, it makes a big difference. But Amplify with Chaos Knight, like Amplify damage from the Slardar plus Chaos Knight, he will one-shot anybody late game. It doesn't even matter if you're Terrorblade or not.
Blink in, Cheshire Cat gonna go through. They get the crush. Now they're gonna bring in everything here. 4-man gank secures a kill onto the Faceless Void, and that means Chrono is out of the picture, and this tower will get pushed.
Yeah, I think they might even just forget the tower because Illidan got a DD rune, so he's taking the opportunity going for the rush, and he did pick up an ulti orb, so it might be a Manta rush coming out for him.
Yeah, most likely, getting the most out of those illusions. This Roche is going down very quickly. Again, the Amplify damage is just so strong. And Illidan, he's hitting like a bus right now. That's just one CK. Imagine if he popped Phantasm for this. That'd be a whole mess of them. He's hitting for like 350.
Yeah, if only Phantasm would work on Rosh. Too bad.
I mean, you can have him tank, you can't have him aggro.
Yeah. RMN, solo taking this bot tower. More money for him. He's rich.
Yeah, this Lion's doing fantastically. In terms of net worth, he's surpassing the Void by, like,
top
500.
He's got eyes on the Vengeful.
They
on the Batrider,
oh,
actually.
Oh, Batrider, they go through, they get the crush, they get the amp damage, kick in, not going to connect, Arise, he's flapping away the most he can, he doesn't have the Firefly,
oh.
And he's going to go through, he has that blink, so he will be able to escape.
That was some pretty unfortunate spell usage, we'll say, by Yol. He misses his stun, misses his silence, misses his roll. That was absolutely a kill on Arise there, it was just a total misplay there by Yol, and that can happen from time to time.
Yeah, he's been trying here. His kill participation is quite low, but then again, F5 have only found a couple of kills. We'll see how much Yol's able to have an impact, because Earth Spirit, you really want him to go through and get those nice lockdowns. So a couple more plays like that, and that might cost F5 a couple of very, very important kills, and maybe even their lead.
Yeah, thankfully he has a lot of setup for himself, so he doesn't... It's not really that the burden is on him to land an incredible boulder smash. He's kind of just going to be able to follow up. They have a Lion Blink Dagger and a Slaughter Blink Dagger, so... Hopefully he doesn't miss more disables or spells when people are stunned.
Yeah, there's so much emphasis placed on mobility here for F5. Again, you've got Earth Spirit with his full kit, Lion with the blink, and now a four stab, as well as the Slardar with that blink. So definitely having the tools to hop around the fight.
My God,
oh, man.
Just misses Arise. Nice prediction there by Yol. Almost got some.
Yeah, imagine if he connected, though. That would have been another kill. Batrider with these pretty YOLO plays has to know that the Timbersaw is there to punish every turn.
And it looks like PR wants to take a fight here.
Don't really know if they can lead with Bignum. He's pretty squishy. He's going to pop out the Spirit and not going to commit anything here. They go in, they get eyes, and they back off.
Yes, yeah, it's definitely a problem for PR that they have a Void who's not really farming too well. And the F5 has a Lion who is at 5,000 net worth. So the Lion has more farm than his offlane Slaughter and the enemy's offlaner as well.
Man, he's a king. This guy just finds money around the map. I've saw him play a Night Stalker the other day that was, I want to say, in at least the top two net worth slots up until like 30 minutes. He was just absolutely huge.
Yeah, he's got Blink 4 Steph and level 11 online, and they have a smoke. They've got their timing. CK finished up his Manta. They've got Blink Force. They've got Blink Slardar. They've got literally all the tools they need right now to take a big fight.
They're wrapping around. They're going pretty deep for this one. All the Radiant, they're kind of clustered up in their own jungle. They got a couple here. Dire Vision won't come through. So.
Yeah, this ward is... might pay dividends right here.
They're going to wrap around. But again, Arise with that Blink. If he gets a nice Blink Force to the low ground, he's going to be in some trouble. But already having committed the Firefly, I think this is the perfect time for F5 to strike.
Yeah, let's see if they catch him. Arise seems to be aware.
He's got the TP. Just going to be sitting there.
Oh my god, if they find him. He'll be so sad, but no. No way.
Illidan has completed that Manta style, sitting on 500 gold. Is his next pick the BKB, or can he continue to go for that, you know, offensive fighting build?
The thing is that the BKB is not even, like, that amazing this game. Like, it blocks out a bit of the magic damage, but PR is not really that, like, magic burst heavy, so I feel like if he just gets his illusions to be super tanky, if they don't have, like, ET and Batrider up, clearing out those illusions is going to be, like, almost impossible. So he can really, I think he can really just decide for himself how he feels the game's going, how he feels like after the next fight happens, if he wants to go, like, Ayaskadi, if he wants to go Heart, if he feels like he can even go in AC, maybe even BKB just seems like maybe it's a later option. Especially because he also versus, like, Elder Titan and stuff, you want to be emphasizing a little bit more on armor and Arise.
Oh, almost, man, almost. He was playing around there for a while. I'm very surprised he hasn't been punished more heavily, but again, Batrider, a notoriously slippery hero, and
he's
going to pick himself up the Ogre Club, so are we looking at a BKB Bat?
Yeah, more than likely. Not really sure what other items you get. That'd be pretty weird if you got, like, a Sanjin. Uh-oh, Void.
Gonna go through. Can they lock him down? Oh, the swap out. J4 making the plays. The next guy's coming out. Pasha is gonna get dragged around. Can he go through? He's looking for something. We'll end up just burning. Terrorblade getting the last hit on that. Now, oh, they bring in Illidan, but not gonna go through that. Reality Rift blocked out by goddamn BKB. Now, goddamn hitting so goddamn hard. And over here, they're still waiting on everything. Void still has his chrono. He's getting controlled up. He's running away. He's looking for something here. They will get the kill onto Yol. And that's gonna be Cheshire Cat not having to commit his ultimate to have an impact in that fight. 0 for 2. Looking good for PR.
He just TP'd to the wrong tower.
Did he really?
I think he tried to TP home, and he TP'd to the tier 2 right next to him. That was
you got
a little bizarre.
You got that whole distance covered, man. Nice work.
So Aegis reclaimed. They get 2 kills out of the BKB usage from the Terrorblade, so pretty good there for PR. And yeah, that's one of the beautiful things about having a BKB on the Terrorblade. CK cannot use Reality Rift on you at all. So it's pretty much they have to get the jump on him first with the Slaughter line before they go for the initiations. And I was just about to mention how good of a job F5's been doing of having wards up, but now PR picks up a gem. They're going to start dewarding down all that vision. And PR has actually been a little bit lackluster on their wards around the map. Their vision has been pretty low. They really haven't had the opportunities to push out and get good aggressive wards down.
Now, Void holding onto that Chrono, a bit stingy with the usage. Cheshire Cat, you know, why didn't he pop that in the last fight to get assured kills instead of, you know, hoping and praying and leaping after his targets?
Not really too sure. He might have just felt like he didn't want to commit too much for the fight. They'd already committed 2 ultimates, and also just he wasn't really in like that great of a position to get into the fight. He's very easily, he's the most susceptible to dying, and he's pretty much the most important ones for F5 to go in. We do have Ryze getting that most damage done by 25, kind of expected because it's a core Batrider.
Yeah, I mean, he's had a couple of deaths, but his impact around the map has been pretty huge.
Or because it's a mid Batrider, sorry. Yes, Batrider tends to be core. Good job, me. Oh, man.
You know, position 4, jungling Batrider, whatever, roaming Batrider.
It was a thing. Once upon a time.
Yeah. Way back when. Now, down bottom, Pasha going to go through that push. And Slardar, he's squiggling around here. He's got 1,000 gold on top of his blink. Does he go for that 4 staff, or does he go for a BKB? Kind of, I don't know.
He can, I would think probably the 4 step here. He doesn't really even, his job in these fights isn't really to be in the midst of everything, just like with a BKB. He just needs to be getting in and out of the fights, dropping as many stuns and amplifies as possible. And we do have a smoke coming out for PR.
The Roshan not quite up yet, but they could go through. J4 sitting there with that swap combo at the ready.
F5 has the high ground here.
Oh, but they're looking. Arise gets an invis rune. It's going to pop right into it. Goes through. The crush is going to come out, but the phantasm to dodge out the lasso. The firefly is coming in. He's frogged up. He's burning, leaving a trail of destruction behind him. Now, the CK illusion's doing a whole lot of work to goddamn. Goddamn. Still sitting on the BKB. Hasn't popped it up just yet. And once again, Void not committing the chrono as PR just back off. It's kind of just a very scared fight. Both teams going, oh crap, they're here.
I'm not sure if my thing was bugged because like I'm having a lot of vision issues, but did his reflection create illusions from the phantasm illusions?
I don't think so.
I thought it could just be like this computer being crazy because it's having like a lot of graphical issues during this game, but I thought I saw that. That was very weird to say. I'm probably wrong, but...
I was more focused on the fact that Batrider was a frog, like, farting out a trail of fire, so
yeah.
That drew my attention in that fight. But again, no blood off the back of that, so a little bit of wasted time from F5, but they're going to be not scared. Goddamn, just going through, TPing out. Now F5, they're pushed in. Do they want to go for any sort of, like, high ground push here or forcing out more fights? What's their play here? Because in terms of overall net worth, they're kind of losing their advantage. They got to get something going for them.
The farm game. We're going to have a long game here, probably. Just going to be both teams farming up for their items. And it looks like he is going to be going for that heart on Illidan instead of going for the BKB. It's just going to be playing around the Roshans here, pushing their lanes out best as possible. So Timbersaw has to do a really good job of just pushing lanes
out. Oh, down bottom, RMN. He's looking for something. If he can go through, if he can get a pick, there's nice Observer Vision. Dire. They don't bring in the Batrider for this one, so the Dire will keep their eyes up. And
oh my god, are they going to get caught here?
These guys are, oh, there, they bring in the bat. They're going to have to roll out. They book it in. Double TPs as Arise. Not going to get too keen on going in for that lasso, but they do lose that ward.
As soon as they saw the gem, they're like,
roll
out.
Whoa, get out, get out. The big boy has entered the field.
Yeah, I think the next big item for F5 is the Timbersaw's bots. He really needs to just keep these lanes pushed in and being able to just join the fight at any point. Because it looks like F5 does want to take an engagement quite soon before that Roshan starts. And they don't want to give up any extra map control to PR. They still do have their tier 1 bottom, which is actually quite important. Usually the tier 1s aren't super important at this point in the game, but that one is so close to the Rosh pit. But they're going to let the tier 1 drop and have that tier 2 and let them contest there. Much better area for them to battle.
Yeah, I mean, do PR continue to pressure the tier 2? Do they really have to go for this now to get the most out of Metamorphosis? Or can they afford to back off, wait for Rosh, farm up?
I feel like
they're going in. They get the drag. Gonna go. The crush connects onto Goddamn. He's got the BKB at the ready when he needs it. He's also got the Metamorphosis as he does go through, sticking in, popping out those reflections. And again, Chrono being held for now. Illidan going through, trying to get the most out of this, but there's going to be the Chrono from Cheshire Cat. Will he find the right illusion? Looks like not quite. The Earth Splitter will be on the mark. Illidan getting dragged back in. Cheshire Cat just flunked away. We'll get the leap off. Nice magnetize. Yol doing some work here, but Yol just gets plopped down. Now Illidan in that armlet form, trying to fight. They will get the Sunder off. Goddamn. Nice and healthy. BZC. He's trying to stay alive. He's trying to stay fighting. On the back lines, J4 walking back on through in some unfriendly territory. Looks like the Stomp could be their Reality Rift back in. Elder Titan getting plunked. Illidan still alive. They will get the kill on the Terror Blade as well. Two big kills go in the way of PR.
It creates illusions on the Phantasm.
Oh, cool.
I just saw it again. Yeah, I didn't know that that was a thing at all, but that was a great, great fight for F5, but PR just, I think they're just overextending a little bit. I mean, they really wanted to get the tower. They got it. They got a decent initiation, and like we were talking about, the Elder Titan Spirit plus Batrider Lasso lets you get easy opportunities to grab people, but at what cost? You killed a lion and you lost... You lost your Tower Blade, you used your BKB charge, you expended all of your ultimates, and your lanes weren't even in good position. So they get the tower, but they lose pretty heavily on the fight overall.
Yeah, and again, that was another Tower Blade BKB charge. He's farmed up, he's sitting at the top of the net worth, but it doesn't feel like he's having the impact that big Tower Blades have, which is always threatening to push towers, threatening to go high ground at, you know, 15 minutes. Now we're 30 minutes in, and we still haven't seen a whole lot of action coming out of PR.
Yeah, like PR trying to clean up the Phantasm illusions, you could just see they were so tanky they couldn't kill them. There's not enough damage to clear the illusions, and then that's where Terror Blade is just gonna be like, he's gonna be able to look super lackluster in the fight, because if he's not focusing at the right target, like those illusions are extremely tanky. He's just switching between all of them. Even you could see that when he sundered, he didn't find a real hero to sunder. He sundered an illusion.
Yeah. And Illidan, I mean, he is just absolutely beefing up. It does go for that heart, so not going to go for the AC. Now, will Natural Order have a big effect on this, or is it just going to be Illidan being an unkillable raid boss?
And thankfully, he's not an agi hero, so it's not really the biggest deal. He's got Armlet, which gives him that bonus 8 armor when it's activated, and he has Manta as well, which gives him a good amount of agility, which gives him even more armor, even though that does get reduced by the Natural Order. Either way, it's not like the biggest deal, but they should be probably picking up a couple armor items, maybe like a Vlad's on one of the supports pretty soon, or maybe a Vlad's even on the Slardar. Maybe he goes for just the aura build for himself instead of the CK needed to worry about any of that.
Well, speaking of lifesteal on the Vlad's, Faceless Void does have that Morbid Mask going through. Are we going to see really old school Mom Void, or is this going to be a Vlad's eventually?
Probably a Vlad's eventually. Just a casual mask so he could jungle better earlier on was just a decision he wanted to make.
Man, look at Illidan just going through. That was no Phantasm, just Armlet. He is so tanky. Didn't even pop into the illusions. He's got the Manta at the ready. So I don't think F5 want to pressure this, but they're feeling really good. They did lose a couple heroes back there. They tipped the net worth back to zero, but now it's going back in their favor. They've got to get a couple things done before the Terror Blade really comes online, though.
Yep. They actually went for the Yules instead on Timbersaw. I guess it's like Yules is a great item, but I feel like he does need the bots. He needs to just keep this top lane pushed in. He can't let PR be pushing out really like this.
RMN blinking in. Could have got the caught on Arise, but Arise just too slippery. And they're going to go Batrider. Once again, literally playing with fire up against a very aggressive lineup.
Yeah. Doing a good job, though, with Gem. Taking out that brand new ward that RMN just put up.
No, I mean
Elder Titan goes for the... Okay, so he's going for that Solar Crest build that we saw Puppy do on the other Titan. And it's needed. He really needs to get that Solar Crest.
Illidan going through, stealing out the Ancients. And there's not much the Radiant can do about that. They are going to smoke. They're going to look for a play. They're going to have to dive very, very deep if they want to connect on the Timbersaw. And looks like they're not going to be able to get it after all.
Maybe not. Oh, they're going to actually grab... Oh, Arise tried. Very close.
Yo. That's a lot of wasted time. That's a lot of wasted vision. And now they're going to be bringing in Yol, going through, getting the boulder, rocking out. J4 going to be dead before the fight really gets going. And now they still have Illidan going back on through. They get the hex. One hit, one crit is all it takes. Gets down Elder Titan. And goddamn, he's looking for the Sunder, but he gets locked in place. Not going to be able to cast that off. Man,
that
PR crumbling under pressure.
Just so over-aggressive even going for that. Like, they wouldn't even get... I don't even think they can get the kill there. They have only three heroes to follow up with the Batrider. They don't have the Void anywhere near. They don't even have anything to gain there. That's just a kill for a kill. I don't really understand the objective they were trying to gain with that smoke. Sure, I can understand them getting wards up, but going for a kill in the base with the heroes that F5 has to respond to him. Slaughter, who's probably the best hero in the game to catch. They have Earth Spirit, who's probably one of the second best heroes in the game to catch. And now, oh my god, Arise actually gets Blink crushed.
Well, he's gonna get the four step off. Illidan, though, he's just hunting. He pops out that armlet, pops up the mana. He doesn't have enough mana for the Phantasm. Now he picks up a little bit more, but on cooldown.
Yep, still 70 seconds on it, but he feels pretty confident to be able to stand in the front line right now. As I say that, he runs away.
I mean, there's no reason that F5 need to go over-aggressive. They definitely learn that PR can make mistakes. PR are not going to be playing the cleanest Dota of their life, so just be waiting for that. Go in and punish. Now Illidan taking a second stack, or rather a second camp of Radiant Agents, and Roshan going to be a little bit more time on that. Fresh pick up there. Illidan still sitting on the Aegis, so they could look to pressure. They could just look to sit back, because I don't think F5 are playing on a timer now. The CK has gotten big enough where he's not going to fall off to a Terrorblade. Looking at that XP chart, it's starting to get kind of ugly.
Yeah, XP-wise, it's definitely going to get a bit ugly. And they also have a lot of ways to deal with the illusions of Terrorblade. We mentioned it during the draft, that even when the Terrorblade gets huge, Lion is able to kill off illusions instantly. He can hex one, which is not always the best decision, but he can just constantly mana drain them. They have the AoE from the Timbersaw to clear out illusions, as well as the Earth Spirit and the Slaughter. They have the tools that they need on the side of F5 to deal with a very farmed Terrorblade, especially if he gets amped up. If he gets amped, he's just going to... You'll see exactly what happened earlier, pretty much, to the other Titan. He's going to get one-shotted with the Phantasm. Even though it's a Terrorblade, it really doesn't matter versus a Chaos Knight later stages in the game. And it does look like the Courier is bringing out another item for Illidan very soon. It's going to be the AC.
Alright, so maybe not getting the most out of that armor again with that natural order, but okay, they're going to go in. There's the reflections like you're talking about. Good God. All the ponies joining the party, and that's going to be Illidan going in, and he's just wailing away at the tower. It's nothing for him. He's not going to be bad at all. Now, they will go through. They will get the swap. They do get RMN, who's holding a Gem of True Sight. But now, Yol looking to capitalize on this. Gets off a nice magnetize. Illidan, he's wailing away. And they will get the kill. There is going to be the Chrono. Will connect onto BZZ, but he's so survivable. He's got the Bloodstone. He's got the Shiva. He's going to get drag himself back on through. Looks like the Stomp comes out. The Earth Splitter rocking through from Vigna. But again, they can't really find much. They do get down Illidan, as his Aegis was going to be consumed already. They get down the Lion. They lose the Venge. They're looking for more. Can they get Pasha? That would be a big pick.
Did the Aegis tick out mid-fight?
Yes, the Aegis just went down. Sucks, man.
That is horribly unfortunate, but maybe a bit over-aggressive by them anyway, just pushing up on the high ground so far. Either way, extremely unfortunate there for F5. They even lose. They dropped the gem which they had. Was that on their gem, or was that... I can't see it. Okay, I can actually see it now. So it was F5 gem. So they just lose a fresh gem that they just bought.
Yeah, they put it on the line there to get that vision to go through and try to get the ward game back in their favor, but not going to work out. Now, the net worth is going to be still heavily in F5's favor, but they can only afford to lose a couple more fights like that, a couple more pickoffs, and PR are very much still in this. Again, the ability to turn those picks, turn those fights into objectives is huge, and Terrorblade is one of the best heroes to do so.
Yeah, big fight for him. If he's able to get a butterfly up, it'll be extremely beneficial to him, because CK is not one of those heroes that will ever build a MKB, so I wouldn't be too surprised to see Terrorblade go for that after...
He's picking up an Assault Kuros.
Okay, never mind.
He starts with the recipe, so just perhaps buying out in case he got in a tough situation that fight.
I really thought the butterfly would be the better decision here, but I guess he feels that the amplified damage is overwhelming. But that's a little weird to me, at least. I really thought he would go for the butterfly, just because of CK is not an MKB builder by any means. But I guess he just felt like he needs the armor, and it's also, like you were mentioning, it's an objective item, so he can siege a little bit harder with that if they do get a good fight opportunity.
Yeah, all it takes is a couple picks. You get Illidan down again, you get BZZ down again, and you can whack out a lane, and the AC is going to be so good for breaking high ground. So PR, they're still hopeful that they're going to get back in the fight, push out the lanes, and start to be the aggressors.
Yeah. They're going to have the solo crest as well on the other Titan soon, so that's going to be at least some evasion that'll be going on top of the other Titan. Or on top of the Terrorblade.
We got a solar crest on F5 as well, Slardar picking that one up. And, you know, it's a little bit unusual to see the Slardar go right for that solar crest, but I do like the evasion. I do think the armor is going to be super important.
I think it's a good build. Like we were saying, he doesn't really need the BKB. It's nice, it's a luxury, but this can provide more of what his hero is meant to do. He's always just meant to just weave in and out of the fights, get as many crushes and amps as possible, throw a Solar Crest on top, why not? It's great for that, and it also helps for sieging and as well for the Roshan. And also the same concept, Terrorblade is not a hero which really has the room to build an MKB, so if he does throw it on the CK, it's also one of those big opportunities for the miss rate.
Alright, Arise. He's got that invis rune, but just going through, taking out the vision. May actually get punished here. The crush comes in. Pasha, it was all the plan all along. They're going to go dunk everything onto this. The Finger of Death coming through. RMN now doesn't have that nuke damage for next fight. But Pasha, he's looking for more. He gets that amp damage onto J4. Do they have the pull here? VZZ going in with the Timber Chain. They get the crush again. And that's going to be a dead Venge. She's having a bit of a tough time. BZZ does go through, pick up that Vengeance aura, but he doesn't really need his right click damage anyway.
Yep, they recover their, not their gem, but they take PR's gem from the Batrider. Good opportunity sees there. They get some nice wards down in the meantime, as well as just pressure on the map. They're going to be able to suffocate PR a little bit off of that.
All right, so Timbersaw now, with that Scythe of Ice pickup, what's that going to mean in terms of control in these fights?
I think it's a great pickup. Like, overall, Hex is just an incredibly good item. He's looking extremely strong on the Timbersaw as well, but Hex, the more Hex is, the more lockdown, the better for a Terror versus a Terrorblade and a Void. Once their BKBs are down, they're super susceptible to just dying. If they get disabled, if the Illidan's still alive, it's going to be a really quick death for them.
Illidan, he does have almost 2,500 gold. Does he level out those boots into Boots of Travels, or does he sell Midas into his next big item? What's he looking for here?
Your illusions don't really benefit too much from eating the Moon Shard, so he can just wait, decide what he wants to do. I think keeping the Midas is probably a good idea, just because the way this game is looking like it's progressing, it's just going to continue on. So probably picking up the Boots of Travel soon, then replacing the Midas with probably an Ayaskati. You usually just want to get stats up. I don't even know if the BKB is entirely necessary, but he might even just do it just to be able to avoid dealing with any of that lockdown and just being able to get through PR's lineup and just get to that back line and be able to get on top of the Elder Titan, get on top of the Batrider.
Speaking of Batrider, once again pushed out very aggressively, does have some backup in the form of Cheshire Cat, but he's going to TP back to this mid lane as everyone, they're grouping up here. Could they go for a big play? Looking at smokes, they will have one. They're going to be rotating into their jungle here. They could catch out F5 unaware. The problem is Pasha, his reaction speed is so quick with that Blink Crush.
They know something's up. Yol's there. He's got a blink dagger. He gets the blink off before the lasso goes off. He gets the roll off as well. And he's safe.
Yol with really fast reaction there. My Dota TV bugged and I couldn't hit the right key. So unfortunately I missed watching the blink, but could see the cooldown come out.
There was no hero for me, so I feel your pain. Don't worry.
Yeah, we've had a couple bugs so far. But oh, looks like they want to go in here. RMN could be the victim here. Cheshire Cat, he's going to get hexed up. He does have the chrono at the ready. Can they get it off? The Finger of Death comes out. They want to control Cheshire Cat. They get him down. The Faceless Void is out before the fight even starts. He's going to go through. He will buy back. Illidan actually going to control it up. There's going to be a drag coming out. Can they get him down? He's just too big. Goddamn, stuck in place. Four staffed away. Chaos Bolt comes out. They get the swap back in. Everyone taking the stomp. Illidan goes down. He has no or he does have buyback, but it's going to be very expensive if he goes for it. Now, goddamn, he's getting low as well. Pasha wants to go in, but will take a stun. Can he get anything done? No. He gets picked off. Goddamn, with a triple kill, he's a pig. And looks like the Timbersaw will not get the latch. This could be a full wipe. BZZ popping out. He goes for the defensive yules. They're looking for more. Will they have it? He's stuck in place. Once again, the bash means he can't get out. Five-man wipe. They only lose the Tyra Blade, and they have to buy back on the Void, but that is certainly worthwhile.
There was either a lot of miscommunication or just too much going on in the team fight, because F5 spell usage was incredibly good on the Void, and then afterwards they just kind of like, they were very confused, like Illidan spam ping on top of the Terrorblade, like this is the real one or something, but Terrorblade can be your last target. You really need to get rid of this Elder Titan. He is doing so much in that team fight. He got multiple stomps off, he had the natural order on top of everybody,
Solar
Firefly, everything, like Solar Crest as well. you need to get rid of this Elder Titan in the fights. You can't be so naive to go for a Terror Blade and thinking that you could just burst him down like that.
Alright, too low mana to go for that lasso. Now Yol going in, just trying to 1v1 the bat, but that means he wasn't able to go through and look for the snipe. So Faceless Void actually picking up the Aegis here. Cheshire Cat may end up burning it right away. In fact, will. And it looks like he might get punished again. RMN sitting there. He has the Earth Spike at the ready. How quick can he react? Not quick enough. Cheshire Cat locked in place. There's the crush. Again, no chance to chrono. This Void has been not popping into those purple bubbles a whole lot, but at least that's some gold going the way of PR. I don't know. Was that all right?
It's a just denied Aegis, so F5 doesn't get it at least. It's okay, but losing your Void twice, he just bought back, so 60 seconds, no Void. This is F5's opportunity to go high ground for a bit. They have Phantasm in 8 seconds as soon as Illidan is there, and they're going to have to siege a bit.
Alright, BZZ looks to be the aggressor there. They go and they get the Hex. J4 may end up being victimized once again, but they get the Dragon to BZZ. He's super tanky, and he will have that Hex up. He has the defensive Yules on himself. RMN draining down, trying to clear out these illusions. Pasha, he's sitting there. They bring in Illidan now. Earth Splitter really off the mark, not getting anything. Goddamn, getting victimized. Swap back. J4 giving his life to save his core, and it's worthwhile. He goes for the Sunder. I believe that was an illusion Sunder. As Goddamn, is now BKB'd. Oh, God. Look at those horses. They're doing so much work. They will go through. They will get the kill onto the Slardar. Now they're looking for more Arise, sucking everyone back through into the fight. Goddamn, he's going to take down to the Magnetize in the end. And looks like Arise is, all right, Yol, he's out. Arise is BKB'd. He's going to be flapping back to base, but BZZ, he's fighting to the bitter end. He goes once again for the defensive Yules. There will be the stomp at the ready. There's the Hex, but BZZ falls. They're looking for the last pickup here. Illidan walking back again with the heart. He's super survivable. Somehow Yol's still alive.
So Reflection doing some work.
Man, that was like a cavalry coming out with the amount of horses we saw.
It looks so weird. It's such a weird interaction too, because it's supposed to be heroes, but I guess Phantasm counts as hero units in a banner.
That's probably the first pro game we've seen that interaction, because Terrorblade and CK, not super meta picks.
Yeah. I haven't seen these two verse each other in ages. So that's maybe a bit of a recent change that people just didn't really know about, because it says all nearby enemy heroes.
But
so I guess that
CK illusions hit for hero damage, like on Phoenix Egg and stuff.
Yeah, I guess so. It's
weird. All right.
Some interactions are just interesting, and it's not like it clears out the illusions or anything, but it causes chaos in the fight, which is already a chaotic situation.
Yeah, I mean, we had there Illidan starting to panic. He didn't really know what to go for. He went for the Reality Rift and tried to book it out of there, and he did end up living. He didn't fall, but that's on the back of having a heart, an AC, and a toggled on armlet. I mean, he was taking so much damage there.
Yeah, and now he's getting some sustainable lockdown through the BKBs. He's picking up himself an Abyssal Blade, which is going to be really, really relevant.
Yeah,
but they need to find a way to get into the back line a little bit better.
Pasha goes through, gets the crush, but little does he know the rest of the Radiant are there. They get the drag. They're just playing with their food at this point. Goodbye, Pasha. Elder Titan. Stomping him down.
Splat. Arise now going to be having the Shivas, but F5 needs to find a way of getting into the back line during these fights, because they can't, like we were saying, they can't just like go on top of the Terror Blade. There's an Elder Titan there to follow up with stomps, which is going to be devastating for your team because he amplifies all the damage that you guys take. There's Venge there for the swap as well, so they need to find a way to get into that back line and get a proper counter initiation. But now it's just gonna keep getting harder. Venge is now level 16, so he's got the max range swap, and pretty much everybody on the side of PR are finding the levels which they need. They're all level 16.
Yeah, the level disparity is huge here. Lion, he'll get his level 16 relatively soon, only needs a couple more waves in the back of that, but Earth Spirit, that Magnetize, not going to come out for a while. The support's definitely doing very well in terms of XP on the Radiant.
Yeah, BZZ, however, did just pick up his Aghanims now, so his damage gets amplified pretty exponentially just from that, and now he has an insane amount of damage to clear up illusions, as well being able to burst out single targets. And the BKBs on the side of PR are starting to tick down, and we do see, okay, so Goddamn does respond to that Solar Crest, and he builds up a MKB on Terrorblade rather than having that Dragon Lance. So very interesting pickup there for him. Still not opting to go for Butterfly. Feels like he needs the damage, not the survivability.
Yeah, and I also just like the mini bash chance on the MKB. I think that's going to do a lot of work, especially against heroes that are so slippery, like the Timbersaw, like the Earth Spirit. You give them one little bop when they're trying to roll away, and well, they're not going to have such a fun time with that. Now Arise is hunting. Again, he's got that lasso up.
Clearing out wards, making sure that there's no vision in their jungle. These fights are going to be pretty much decided on the vision game. Whoever gets the better initiation / counter initiation, depending on what they see during the fights, is going to be the dictator of what happens. Especially also if they can keep killing this Void before he gets the chronos off, it could be really huge, because PR is getting a bit lucky in the fights, because they're losing the Voids pretty much every single time at the start, and they're still coming out relatively even or ahead.
Pasha sprinting around, but realizes all too late that the smoke gank is going to be unsuccessful. They could end up bopping out onto Goddamn. Can they react fast enough? Four staff away. They don't want to fight this. He's slowed down. The reflection coming out. Now they're going to be going on in. Goddamn's metamorphosis is up if he wants to go into that big guy form. He will pop out immediately. Now there's going to be a crush. Pasha, though. Oh, he's just fallen victim to this. The Scotty Terrorblade doing so much work in the back line.
He can be used already on the Terrorblade, though.
They can punish him for this, but oh, the chrono! The horses are just wailing away. Illidan gets popped down. The Earth Splitter comes out. Terrorblade gets the pick, and that's going to be Illidan forced to maybe buy back for this. They're looking for more BZZ, getting punished by that mini bash chance, by that bash from Cheshire Cat. Goes for the defensive Yules, but cannot react fast enough. Vengeful Spirit with the magic missile gets the job done. Cheshire Cat squealing around, but going to feel very happy about those picks. That's a huge loss for F5.
They need to find out this Elder Titan. They keep letting him do everything he wants in these fights. Of course, it's a bit difficult because there's, like we were talking about, PR has a lot of different ways to just get the vision advantage, get the front line. Void pretty much has one job. Chrono, Chaos Knight. Elder Titan has his one job. Use your ult on the Chrono with an Echo Stomp, with your natural order over it.
And just be near heroes,
and just
yeah.
Be near him. And you can see what happened. Like, the BKB was kind of wasted in a way from the Terrorblade, but it didn't matter. Cheshire Cat lands a perfect Chrono on CK, and he gets decimated from the Earth Splitter.
Yul going through, gets a nice kick onto two heroes, but they just don't have the follow-up. They've got the Lion Finger, but that's a big... Oh, Pasha!
Pasha, that's...
He blinked in, but didn't react fast enough with the Crush and just gets punished. Arise on a killing spree, and he is just feeling really good about that. That shouldn't have been a kill on the Slaughter. Now, he's dead for a minute with absolutely no buyback. This is going to be at least a set of racks going the way of PR. We talked about how quickly Terrorblade can capitalize on objectives, and it's happening, man. God damn, he might get stuck there. It's going to be a swap back. J4 buying some time, but Yul getting punished up here. May end up going down. Just a reflection. It's going to end here. RMN taking some heavy damage as well. What a big stomp there. Now BZZ getting stuck in place. There will be TPs out from the rest of PR. They're not able to go through. RMN can't get the Earth Spike off in time. This is F5 reacting very, very poorly to this pressure.
Yeah, both teams seem to be cracking a little bit under the pressure. Some questionable spell usage in some of the situations, but also just some weird positioning mistakes there. The Slaughter was pretty crazy. Like, he was super far in front there. He gets caught out, but either way, they're probably going to lose the racks there anyway, but it does force out the Timbersaw to buy back, and now they have a window of opportunity if they do kill that Timbersaw. Even though he has Bloodstone, he will be dead for a good window of time if he dies soon.
Yeah, I mean, that Bloodstone down to 6 charges, so certainly not, like, the absolute GG item that it can be.
Yeah, and it's just, right now it's becoming a little bit just easier for PR to take fights. They have, their heroes literally have, like, one or two jobs each. They need to just land the Chrono on top of the CK. Meanwhile, F5 has to, like, do a ton of different things to properly lock down several different heroes on the side of PR. So PR has the ease of execution in these team fights currently.
Alright, so just kind of a... old standoff here. No one wants to be the first one to engage. BZZ throwing up a Chakram. And they are going to scout out PR. And Illidan, he's running up. He will go through. Only one reflection being used. Goddamn goes in. Once again, the BKB down very, very short. Arise. He's going to get the drag off. J4 going to be the first to fall. Cheshire Cat. Oh, the stomp coming out. Elder Titan putting in the hours. Goddamn, ripping apart Illidan. Can they get him down? That's a huge pick. Looks like they might be going in. He gets off the bash, but he's dead. 90 seconds. Will he buy back? Arise getting very, very low, but BZZ cannot afford to go down here. Again, he already bought back. Penny, get out of this alive. He's looking for more. He wants to get the kill. Throwing out the Chakrams. Goddamn going in. They will get the kill. Timbersaw, he's down. 80 seconds. No buyback. Pasha, he's down as well. They're looking for a full wipe here. Lion is slowed up. It looks like this could be the end. He gets off an Earth Spike with his last breath, but that's going to be a triple kill for Goddamn. A full wipe on F5, and PR losing none of their huge cores.
Wow. They got the pretty much instant Hex off on the Void again. He doesn't get the Chrono off. I thought the fight was going to go better for them, but again, they are prioritizing heroes in a very odd manner. I know that they're getting the Void every single time, which is perfect. It's amazing. Like, what more could you really ask for? But they're killing the Venge off basically right afterwards in most of these situations, And that just reduces the damage from the side of the Chaos Knight.
Yul going through. We'll pop out that Magnetize. They get the Silence as well. Trying to force back everyone, but Yul getting victimized just by the raw illusions of the Terror Blade. Now Illidan's back in the party. He does have to buy back. Now he's going to be pretty poor there. Buy back on cooldown. If somehow PR can find another fight off the back of this, they've absolutely won. They're going to get a Roshan, and that's all they need on Goddamn to be able to go through and push high ground.
Yeah, unfortunately he's a little bit slot starved, so I'm not sure what he's going to get rid of for it, and it is Aegis and Cheese, so maybe they're going to just give it to other people, but even the, like, everybody, all the supports on the side of PR, or the two supports on the side of PR are just scaling a little bit better than the side of F5. They have the Venge and the Elder Titan, which scale progressively better and better into the late game than in comparison to the Lion and Earth Spirit. Lion and Earth Spirit do have more disable in a way, but Vengeful, especially with the Terror Blade, you apply a lot more. Especially now he has Aghanims as well, so if he does die in the fights, he still gives the aura to your team, and he reduces the damage of F5's team if he dies to the CK.
So the Courier was taken out in this shot by a Terror Blade illusion. It had 3,600 net worth on it. Is that, what was that? I didn't quite catch it.
Let's take a look at it. It was probably Odin's Abyssal.
Damn, that's a big item that he needed in this fight. If he can Abyssal down Goddamn before he's able to go through and BKB and Metamorphosis, that's an easy kill and that's a stall out to the fight. But without that, he's just going to have to rely on some RNG bashes.
Yeah, just like I was saying before, PR just has the ease of execution in these fights right now. Especially if they get Chrono off. Like, they've been winning fights without Chrono a lot of the time.
Oh, going back in there. There's going to be a drag here onto BZZ. He can't afford to go down. The Chrono comes in. Illidan, fallen victim here. Looks like the Earth Splitter coming in. They do get the kill. That could be the GG. 100 seconds. No CK. No anyone here. Three dead. The only survivors are going to be the Lion and the Timber. And this is looking really, really good. Goddamn, coming back with a vengeance here. We did see PR falling down early game, but with these tier 4s falling, look at this net worth climb. Almost 20,000 in the last 5 minutes. God, now BZZ, he comes back in. He's trying to get what he can done. This is Hail Mary territory, and Yul immediately falling down. BZZ looks like he's next in the menu. They're going to go through. They're going to whack him out. And J4, oh, he's looking for everything here. J4 hitting like a champ. Goddamn, helping out. And that's going to be tier 4s. That's going to be Ancients. In these best of ones, anything can happen. It looks like PR will claim a game for themselves. F5. Now they've got a very steep road ahead of them.
Yeah, F5 was coming out 3-1 into this game. PR coming in 1-3 into this. And that's hugely beneficial to them. They needed this win. And that should give them good spirits to start off their day.
Absolutely. All my predictions are wrong, but that doesn't matter here. Again, we are going to be going doing a couple of best of ones for you today after this end screen here. Let's go ahead and cut back to our camera here. I'm Android. That's Fogged. And what did you think of that game? Like, what happened? It seemed like F5 had such a nice early lead. What was the slip-up?
It just seemed like they overextended a few times. Like, that top base push, they were like really far past the tier 3. And just overall, like I was mentioning in the fights, Power Rangers just has easier execution. They have the vision game. We've been talking about it like throughout multiple different tournaments. It's like pretty much the team that has the easier execution and easier like initiation factors tends to win these fights. And also, I know Blitz loves to mention this, it's about these scaling supports. Elder Titan and Vengeful Spirit scale progressively all throughout every stage of the game. Of course, Lion and Earth Spirit do as well, but not in the manner of these two heroes. Like, Elder Titan and Vengeful literally just need to be there. They just need to be standing there, and they're doing their job. And, yeah, like, the lineup for Power Rangers just ended up getting more and more well-rounded as the game progressed. Void just needs to chrono one hero, pretty much, and Bignum just needs to ult one hero. They just need to kill the CK, and it was happening pretty much in all the fights. Then Timbersaw would get kind of kited around, get disabled from, like, one or two things, and then just get bursted down. So PR did a really good job in those team fights and just identifying what they needed to do.
All right, yeah, and in the end, it seemed like Illidan versus the world. So
yeah.
Hopefully, F5, they'll be able to get it together for their next couple of matches coming up. Next up, we are going to go hop into Virtus Pro versus Ad Finem. Going to be an action-packed series, so stick around. More best-of-one coverage coming up in a few minutes.